Wednesday morning, time to get up and plow through the middle part of the week. And we're glad that you chose to take us with you this morning. We appreciate the ride here on the archives on WCLU. We enjoy talking about our heritage, our history. We enjoy talking about some of the special things that have occurred here of late. And just put a little bug in your ear about something that's coming up on the 27th. This is the 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock on Saturday, the 27th, South Central Kentucky Cultural Center. Remember the Forgotten War of Korea. I think that is going to be fascinating, Sam.
It will, and there are multiple presentations that take place as a part of that program. I have seen the outline for it, and it's going to be a special program. You don't want to miss that.
I'm excited to know about it, because there's a lot to learn about that, and I'm sure it's going to be well done. But just get that on the calendar there. The 27th is when that will be up at the Cultural Center. Let's see. You ready to go back down 100 years?
Oh, yes.
Let's journey backwards down to 1924, the 17th day of 1924 of April. In the Glasgow Times, we have some more school notes here. Listen to this one. Miss Louise Burks, than whom the city school has never graduated a better pupil, has been elected assistant news editor of the Kentucky Colonel, which is the official newspaper of the University of Kentucky.
That's quite an accomplishment.
That is, and quite a nice way to say, you know, to sit here and to say point blank, Miss Burke, the city's never graduated a better pupil. That's a lofty title for sure. But certainly the Kentucky Colonel, you've made it when you're the involved in management of that place for sure. Congratulations to Miss Burks. Let me get over here to 1934. What was the mood of things here? Well, we were talking about the musicale here in 1934. The matinee musicale of Glasgow has been awarded the highest state rating among the 28 music clubs that are members of the Kentucky Federation of Music Clubs. Mrs. Sewell Harlan of Glasgow is the president of the matinee musicale. You know, of all the wonderful different civic organizations and activities we've had here, one of the one that certainly has stood the test of time is the matinee musicale.
It certainly has. You know, founded in 1894, that's no simple thing,
right,
to still be active all these years later.
That's right, and it's certainly what a heritage, what a history. I'm sure that there are lots of histories about the different things the musicale has done that we probably should look at more than we do, Sam.
We should.
1954. The J.J. Newberry store in Glasgow is soon going to begin an extended remodeling program at its North Public Square location. This is the third remodeling stint of the store in its 24-year history in the city. Mr. J.H. Tuller, who's the manager of the store, who has been the manager for 22 of its 24 years, said the remodeling would include the installation of a 30-stool lunch counter. Did you ever wonder how many stools were there?
It was a long row.
It looks like you could say that might be 200. When you're a little kid going in there, wow, how far is it down there to the end?
And as I also recall, there were usually people waiting for one of those stools to be vacated so they could have a seat and order a Newberry's Mexican hamburger.
That's exactly right.
With coleslaw.
Excellent pickles on and coleslaw for sure. 30 stools. That solves one of the mysteries, doesn't it? 1964, the Glasgow Times reporting that Leslie Moran has been named the executive manager of the Glasgow Chamber of Commerce. That was a position he held for a number of years with honor, for sure. Mr. Les Moran. 1974, we've got news about four Glasgow High School students who are taking the oath of enlistment in the Navy. The 180-day delay program signed up for by Stephen Ray Slayton, Robert Barry Stone, Joe Stephen Bunch, and Terrell Wayne Smith. Those are all young gentlemen that I went to school with there back in 1974. Good fellas as well. And that 180-day delay program. Of course, we were transitioning into, you know, they're going to be ending the draft, and they were coming up with creative ways to recruit soldiers, and this 180 delay was one of the things they were trying to do. Let's go to 1984. We've got news about Okus Fields. Okus finished first in the Gilco Singles Classic Bowling Tournament at Freedom Lanes. Ricky Wood, the manager, presented him with a trophy and a $500 check. My goodness. Bringing home the bucks for winning that big tournament out there for Mr. Okus Fields in 1984. It was 1994. We have this story about Glasgow's newest restaurant, Burger King. It's open for business at the corner of the bypass and Rogers Road. The manager is Mike Whitlow. So, you know, we had Burger Queen for a while.
We did.
We had royalty out there, and now here's Burger King coming to open in 1994. What I remember about that is that it seemed like it rained the whole time they built that building out there. It's like, how in the world, you know, it had to, long after it opened, it was still drying out somewhere underneath, because that was a really messy construction back in 1994.
And 30 years later, going strong.
That's exactly right. That's the way it works out. Here we are in 2004. We've got news about the In and In Outdoor Company, owned and operated by Jerry and Jeff Noe, located at 5566 Glasgow Road in Edmonton. It's the area's newest ATV, dirt bike, and accessory store, In and In Outdoor. And here we go to 2014. The Cave City Chamber of Commerce this day presented the Business of the Month, Kentucky Action Park and Jesse James Riding Stables. It's certainly fitting that at the beginning of the tourist season for that year, they have those two to be noted as Businesses of the Month. And that's where we are in the way of history today, Sam Terry.
Well, another good day of archival information.
That's right.
Brings back a lot of memories.
Yes, it is. A lot of fun to talk about things. And I don't know how you are, but it seems like I connect a few dots every day on this program and learn a little bit more about how things are connected. And we hope everybody will come back and join us again tomorrow so we can do the same, okay?
We'll see you then.
Thanks for joining us today for the Archives here on WCLU.